हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेक्चर नंबर 10 ऑन ऑप्टिक्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द माइक्रोस्कोप इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप एंड इन दिस लेक्चर देयर इज अ कंपाउंड माइक्रोस्कोप। सो व्हाट इज कंपाउंड माइक्रोस्कोप? ए माइक्रोस्कोप हैविंग एट लीस्ट टू लेंसेज including an objective and an eyepiece. We know that in simple microscope we have used one lens, and in compound microscope we use two lenses including an objective and an eyepiece. So compound microscope. So as we seen, in compound microscope we have used the two lenses. So here consider that this is the first lens and this is your second lens. So first lens is called as the objective lens. That means this lens will be near to the object, will be nearer to the object, and this is called as the eyepiece. This lens is nearer to the eye, so it is called as the eyepiece lens and it is called as the objective lens. Then objective is the converging lens nearer to the object. Eyepiece is the converging lens through which the final image is seen. So both are of short focal length. Focal length of eyepiece is slightly greater than that of the object. Let us see here, this is your first lens and this is your second lens. The first lens is called as the objective lens. The objective lens is nearer to the object, and the second lens, that is the eyepiece, is nearer to the final image in which we have to see. Then the focal length. This is the focal length of this lens. Length is smaller as compared to the focal length of this eyepiece. So angular magnification or magnifying power, it is denoted by m. So angular magnification or magnifying power of a compound microscope is defined as the ratio of the angle beta subtended by the final image at the eye to the angle alpha subtended by the object seen directly when both are placed at the least distance of distinct vision. So we get m is equal to beta upon alpha. Let us see here in diagram. This is your beta and the angle subtended, this is your alpha. So with both the angles are very small. Then since the angle are small, alpha is equal to tan alpha and beta is equal to tan beta. Therefore this equation can be written as m is equal to tan beta upon tan alpha. Therefore m is equal to, what is tan beta? Tan beta is a double dash b double dash upon d. Let us see here, tan beta is A double dash upon B double dash upon BD. Then tan alpha is B upon A double dash A dash. Therefore m is equal to A double dash B double dash upon D into D upon AB. So here DD will be cancelled. What is D? D is the least distance of distinct vision. So here DD will be cancelled and we get m is equal to A double dash B double dash upon AB. So A double dash B double dash upon A dash B dash. So m is equal to A double dash B double dash upon AB, that is equal to A double dash B double dash upon A dash B dash into A dash B dash upon AB. Here A dash B dash will be cancelled. Therefore, we get A double dash B double dash upon AB. Then M is equal to ME into M0. What is ME? ME is the magnification power or magnification of eyepiece, and MO is the magnification of objective. Magnification of objective. So ME is equal to 1 minus FE upon F, VE upon FE. Let us see here. This is the objective, ME. MO means the magnification of objective, and ME is the magnification of eyepiece. So ME is equal to 1 minus VE upon FE. VE is the image distance of eyepiece, and FE is the focal length of eyepiece. Or ME is equal to 1 plus D upon FE, where D is the least distance at distinct vision, and FE is the focal length of eyepiece. We know that the VE, if we consider VE is equal to minus D, that is equal to minus 25 centimeters. We need know that the least distance of distinct vision is nothing but the 25 centimeters. Therefore, M0 is equal to, and also MO. MO means magnifying power of objective. That is equal to V0 upon U0. What is V0? V0 is the image distance of objective, and U0 is the object distance of objective. Therefore, M is equal to V0 upon minus U0 in bracket 1 plus D upon FE. Then, since the object is placed very close to the principal focus of the objective and the image is formed very close to the eyepiece, therefore U0 is nearly equal to F0 and V0 is nearly equal to L. So U0 is the distance of object is nearly equal to F0, means distance of object is nearly equal to the focal length of object, and V0, that means the final image, the image of objective is nearly equal to the length. So M is equal to minus L upon F0 in bracket 1 plus D upon FE. D upon FE. Minus, what is L? L is the length. Let us see here. This is the length of objective length to eyepiece length. L is the distance in between the two lenses, that is the objective length and the eyepiece. Then M is equal to minus L upon F0 in bracket 1 plus D upon FE, or M is equal to minus L upon F0 into D upon FE. Therefore, normally adjustment, that is the image at infinity. So the magnifying power capital M is equal to ME into MO. ME into MO. We know that the ME is the magnifying power of eyepiece and MO is the magnifying power of objective, where ME and MO are the individual magnifying power of objective and eye lens. Also, the magnifying power M is equal to V0 upon U0 in bracket 1 plus D upon FE. When the final image is at near point, then the final image is at near point. That where is the V0? V0 is nothing but the objective image, objective lens image upon U0 is the distance, object of distance of objective in bracket 1 plus D upon FE. What is D? D is the least distance at distinct vision, and FE is the focal length of eyepiece. Also, When the final image is at infinity, we get m is equal to v0 upon u0 into d upon fe, into d upon fe. So in this case, the magnification power when final image is at near point, we get this equation. And if the final image is at infinity, we get this equation. Then last, uses of compound microscope. A compound microscope is of great use in pathology lab so as to identify the diseases. Also, various crime cases are detected and solved by drawing out human cells and examining them under the microscope in forensic laboratory. So this is about the compound microscope. So thank you.